So if tenants leave properties leaving unpaid utilities, that's really got nothing to do with a landlord. Utility contracts are a contract between the utility provider and the tenant. If the tenant's in breach of that contract and hasn't paid the bill, it's not the landlord's problem. Key points for the landlord, of course, are to make sure the utilities are in fact transferred to the tenant to begin with. So landlords should be notifying utility companies that the property is rented and that it's being taken over. Otherwise, if the tenant doesn't transfer the contract, then the landlord's going to end up with the bill. But that's just kind of carelessness and bad management, really. And then other than that, they should be making sure they have a copy of the tenancy agreement to show to the utility company if the utility company questions it later. There are sometimes practical difficulties where different types of meters are being installed or where things have been shut off, but by being bullish and aggressive with the utility company and saying, you have no right to shut off my power, you have no right to change my meter, it's usually possible to get to reinstate supply. In theory, the introduction of smart meters, when they finally get fully introduced and work properly, should help with this issue, because smart meters, of course, can be dynamically changed between pay-as-you-go meters and normal meters, and even turned off remotely. So it should help with this as we move forward, but we're still quite a long way from a fully functioning smart meter system.